Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2308, 52 Trailing Weeks with Sequence. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gill, and today we're going to take a look at one of the new dynamic array functions called Sequence. And when this one initially came out, I said, oh, this is really silly. But Sequence can do a whole bunch of things. Four arguments, only the first one is required, which is the number of rows, and optionally the number of columns, the starting number, and the step number. If you don't provide these three, it's going to be one column wide, starting at one, stepping by one. So just very easily here, Sequence, let's say 1,000, will generate 1,000 numbers like that, right? Super easy to do. But you can customize this a little bit. If we want to go from 5 to 10, jumping by 1 equals Sequence. Let's see, I need 6 rows. Don't need it to be more than one column, so I can skip the number of columns. Start at 5, don't need to say it's stepping by 1. So just close, and I get 5 to 10. Or here, let's do odd and even numbers. So equals Sequence. I'm going to do 10 rows, 2 columns, and I get the odd and even numbers from 1 to 20 broken out. But hey, this was cool. I was doing a seminar, one of my last live seminars in Springfield, Missouri, and Lisa was there, and I was going through over Sequence, and Lisa, you know, shouted out from the back and said, hey, we have a report where we have to create 52 trailing weeks. So going from today backwards, the last 52 weeks, and Sequence would be great at that. We're going to have 52 rows, one column, and where are we going to start? We're going to start at today. Today is a great function that gives us the current day, and then the step is going to be negative. So minus 7, that way we'll go from today's date, and then the previous week, the previous week, the previous week, and so on, like that. All right, now, one hassle with this is that Sequence is expecting numbers, so it's not smart enough to format things as dates. So I'll choose all that data, Control Shift down arrow, and then choose short date or long date or whichever you need. This reminds me of another one from Excel MVP Roger Govier, creating a forward-looking calendar. So equals Sequence. We want 5 rows, 7 columns, because there's 7 days in a week, starting from today. And then the step will just automatically be 1. And again, right numbers, wrong format. We'll format that as a short date. Actually, you know, since it's a calendar, we can do this. Control 1 and come in here just something like that. Perfect. And then to get the days of the week, we'll say equal text. Now, this is pretty cool. I'm going to choose 7 numbers here. Text is expecting just one number there, but now thanks to dynamic arrays, text can accept all 7. And the format will do DDD to spell out the or to do the day abbreviation, something like that. All right, great new function here called Sequence. You know, it's not as sexy as sort and filter and unique, but there's a lot of very cool things that we can do with Sequence. Now, the Excel Dynamic Arrays book, I know a lot of you have this first edition. I gave the first edition away for free. I've updated it to a second edition, just $3. Click I in the top right hand corner. If you like what you see here on the podcast, please subscribe and ring that bell so you get notifications when there is a new video. And feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments section below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.